Today we're talking to Chuck Conrad, Senior Financial Planner at Zarka Financial in North Olmsted. And today we're going to talk about romance scams. Good to have you here today.
Thanks for having me.
I'm a doctor and you're a financial advisor. Is there anything our careers have in common?
Jim, I'd like to think so. I'd like to think that people should view their financial advisor as the person that they share their financial secrets with, much like they view their medical secrets with their doctor in the path to a diagnosis. I think it's absolutely critical that you have an open line of communication with your advisor, and this is something that I have to remind my female clients of quite frequently.
We're talking about romance scams. Where does this fit together?
It fits together because while it can be said that men are too stubborn to stop and ask for directions, when it comes to women, my experience tells me that they're often very reluctant to share tales of when they've been embarrassed. And because of that, not a whole lot is out there about scams that are going on that can be financially devastating to an awful lot of women.
So this issue of embarrassment and finance are tied together somehow?
It's how it ties together in what I have seen. There are situations, and sadly, you know, criminals, they don't wear ski masks and long trench coats and walk up to us with, a pistol in their pocket and say, "This is a stick-up, give me all your money, put it in this bag." In this day and age with technology, they can steal a picture, create a false identity, and create a profile on Facebook or some other social media site and just start charming their way into people's lives in such a way that before long they're getting access to, you know, financial records and to funds that they otherwise wouldn't have access to.
So what are some of the things that women have to be watching out for specifically to avoid these romance scams?
A couple things that they need to watch out specifically is if they're on a social media site and out of nowhere they get an instant message that pops up from somebody they don't know. We've got to be a little guarded about that. It could be a phishing attempt. If you do have a conversation with that person, look at their profile. If they have eight friends and all eight friends are females in their 50s, that should be a red flag. If they don't have any high school classmates or college classmates, nobody that provides any type of depth to their life outside of this profile, then I would be very cautious as to the communication that I have with them. We see tales of men overseas that are in the military. They will strike up conversation on these social media sites. They'll be very reluctant to share any of their personal information for national security reasons or something like that. People should be advised that most often this is a scam. If you can't share where you're located or what your unit is as a matter of national security, then you have no business being on a social media website to begin with. If they have an emergency that comes up where they need access to funds immediately, the American Red Cross is very helpful in that regard. The service member should be encouraged to contact the Red Cross. If they come back with a retort that, you know, they've tried and nothing is working out, then I would suggest that this is really a phishing attempt to gain access to their funds.
I was saying, I think it must be from another world. These things really happen?
It happens more often than you would believe. And again, it's just like, guys don't stop and ask for directions. Once they've been victimized in this type of situation, they're not likely to go out and create a Facebook status that says, "Hey, guess what just happened to me?" They're going to be very, very quiet about it. That embarrassment causes them to be paralyzed with regard to releasing the information. Sadly, that's one of the reasons why these scams can continue to be successful, is because we don't hear about them that much. So when it does happen, when that message does pop up, the individual on the receiving end of that message can think, this is so strange that you can't make this up. This has to be fate. But I really think they need to be aware that it's out there more often than they would think.
So is the answer education? Is there something else that can be done about it?
I think that people need to be mindful of it. When when they receive a message like that, they need to put an end to it right away. If their smell test is the test that, you know, if it just doesn't smell right, that's the test that I say. I think that's the best way to deal with it. If they have been victimized, I would say for the good of all, to let people know what has happened beforehand. Have conversations with your family and your friends, and if they're all sitting around the kitchen table saying, "You've got to be crazy. You're the only one in this room that's not seeing all of these things add up," pay some attention to that. Typically, they're a pretty good sounding board.
Sounds good. Chuck, thanks so very much for sharing with us about these romance scams.
Thanks for having me.
You can contact Chuck at zarkafinancial.com.